How do you make a cover photo on Pinterest? How do you get a banner onto your Pinterest profile? So if you got questions about how to create a custom photo or video banner for your Pinterest profile, this is the video for you. And if you love Pinterest tips, be sure to give this video a quick thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel because I've got weekly Pinterest training coming your way. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to design a custom banner, image, or video for your profile. I'll share with you those custom sizes, as well as a few steps you need to take in order to be able to add this custom banner. And of course, how to design it in Canva and how to upload it to your profile. So let's get started. The first thing you need to know is that in order to add a custom banner like this one, which I have on my Pinterest profile, you first need a business account. So if you have a personal profile, be sure to check out the links I put down below on how to convert into a business profile or to create a separate one for your blog or your business. You might be wondering, what size should my Pinterest banner be? It should be 800 pixels by 450 pixels. And if you decide to add a video, it should be 16 by 19 ratio, which is the standard ratio of any video that is horizontal. You should know that in order for you to add a video as your cover, you have to first claim your domain, or your Etsy, your YouTube, or your Instagram account is gonna enable you to add a video. So head on over to your Pinterest profile. You're then gonna click on the little down arrow and go to settings. And then you'll notice you have claim right here. This is where you're either gonna claim your website. You can see I've claimed my website. You can also do your Instagram, Etsy, or your YouTube. This is going to enable you to upload a video as your cover image. So just follow the steps to claiming. If it's for social media, you'll simply log in, claiming for your website. I'm gonna put the links down below. You just have to add a bit of code to your site. So let's take a look at some examples of those banners to give you some inspiration. Previously, before Pinterest was updated, you were able to create a banner or Pinterest cover using all of your pins. So we can see here on Carly's profile, this is just a snapshot of what the banners used to look like. But here are a few examples. So Light Mind Body Clinic, for example, has this beautiful image as their cover photo. Over here, Vanessa has this video, which is amazing, right? You can create a video, just a snapshot. There is no audio, but you can upload any videos that you've been using for your business. Boss Babe Chronicles has this lovely animation, just to give you some ideas of what you can do. And we also have Sincerely Students has this beautiful animated banner. So you can see there are so many options, just like in its season, we have this little animation. You can easily create something like this. Even Jessica Carver has this amazing video, which I'm sure she uses for all of her other marketing materials. Something that I do for my own cover banners is make sure all of my banners are the same across any platform. So you can see here that this is my Pinterest banner. It's for the printable or whatever freebie I'm promoting at the moment. So for your banner, it could be about a product, a coming webinar, or it can just be about your content and your site in general. This is the same banner that I have on Facebook and also on Twitter. So no matter what my banner is on Pinterest, it's always gonna be more or less the same image that I create across platform. There's one thing I want you to know when you're designing your banners is that you're gonna wanna make sure that about the bottom fourth doesn't have any key information, because you can see here that your profile picture actually covers that portion of your header image. So you just wanna make sure you keep that in mind when designing. So let's go over to Canva and I'll show you how easy it is to use their existing templates to design a Pinterest cover for your profile. And you can do this on a free Canva account as well. If you haven't signed up for Canva before, I've got a link down below. You can click on it. So here we are on Canva. And I want you to know that they actually do not have a custom Pinterest cover template for you, but that's okay. Using the same ratios, you can actually use YouTube channel art covers. So you can see there are all these covers that are in the perfect ratio for your Pinterest cover. You can also customize a Facebook cover template as well. Just make sure it's not these shorter ones, which are for Facebook groups, but rather that you choose one of the wider templates that we see down here. It's also the same ratio. Third option is to actually even just to use a presentation template. It is the same ratio as the Pinterest covers, that 800 by 450. It's slightly larger, but it works perfectly. So you can go ahead and choose any cover image that you like. So for example, this is a design that I think is stunning. So I'm just going to customize it. So all you would do is just update it. So I'm updating it with the name of my blog. I want to make it a bit larger. So if you want to change the photos, that's easy to do. You're going to click on photos. If it's not appearing there, you're going to click more, and then photos will be an option. You can search for any stock images that match your brand. So say, for example, I want to change this to this beach, for example, or, you know, maybe there's a different image that I want to use, and you can do that here. You can change the colors of the fonts. These are all options that are available to you. So you can upload an image or a video. You've got a few ways to go with this. If you're happy, this is great. You can also animate it. So say, for example, you want it to move, you can do that. You can also add in multiple slides. So say I want to duplicate this and I want to promote a freebie. So I'm going to say, get your free printable self quotes, for example, right? I know I have an upload where I have those quotes. So maybe I'm going to promote this on the second side. So you just gotta make it customized to your brand, what makes sense. This is the first slide, second slide, and I'm gonna say, click the link in my bio. And I'm not sure I'm feeling the desert vibe, so I'm actually just going to find a more, you know, sunny, happy photo. But there you have it. If I want to click the link in my bio, I'm actually just going to add a down arrow, or even this guy's fun. Okay, there you have it. These are three slides that I'm going to go with. So now I have three options. I could upload a single slide as my cover, any one of these, or I can animate them and make them into a video. So we can see here that when you click right here, it has rise as the animation, but you have all of these options. So I'm going to do pan. The second slide, I can do fade. And there we go. So they're each 5 seconds. If you're uploading a video as your cover, it has to be between 4 seconds and 5 minutes long. So say, for example, I want to just animate one slide. I have to make sure it's at least 5 seconds, and we can customize that with timing here. So since I have multiple slides, I'm going to downgrade this to 3 seconds. The total runtime is always right here. And I'm going to put this one down to 3 seconds too, because I don't want people to get bored. And I'll leave this one at 5 seconds. So let's just play it. This is what's going to be in my cover image, get your printable quotes, and click the link in my bio. So now that your video is ready to go, your next step is to download it. So if it's a video, you're going to make sure you download it as an MP4. So just click the down arrow and click MP4 video. These are your options. Make sure all pages are selected, because we want to make one video. It's going to be 11 seconds long. So I'm going to download that. If you just want to upload a single image, so say, for example, you just want to animate the main page, you can do the same thing. Download MP4 video, just select that singular page, and then you're going to click download. If you also just want to have an image, so say you just want the second page, to be the image of your profile, you would just click on PNG, then make sure you select the correct page. So this is page 2. So I'm going to make sure I select that, and then I'm going to press done and download. So there I have multiple options. Our next step is to take our newly designed Pinterest cover and upload it to Pinterest. Remember, you need a business profile, and if you want to upload a video, you have to claim your website or your Instagram, Etsy, or YouTube channel. Our designs are saved. So I'm over on Pinterest and I'm actually just on my profile. I'm going to hover over this pencil. It's going to allow me to update my cover. So you can drag and drop or choose the files. Since I've got them right here, I'm just going to drag and drop my video in. It's going to preview it for you. You can see that it's perfectly sized. Otherwise, you'd have to crop it. And there we have it. It's playing. So I'm going to click save. It's saving our new Pinterest cover image. If you chose a video, it takes a little longer. And there we have it. So you can see here, its profile image is not covering up this. One other tip I have for you is that if you are featuring a product or a freebie like I do in my cover image, you want to make sure that if someone does click the link in your bio, that when they land on the homepage of your website, it's the same thing that you promoted in your Pinterest cover. So I'm promoting my self-confidence printable quotes. It's right there. It's the first thing they see when they click over to my website. So make sure you do the same. So if you found this video on how to create Pinterest cover images or videos helpful, be sure to give it a thumbs up. I'd really appreciate it. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel because I'm more than happy to be your Pinterest coach. And be sure to stick around and check out this video. It's going to be helpful to you. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.